Hello everyone. In this webinar, we'll talk about the media and the social media and how they have been like evolving over the time. So very quickly, first of all, about myself and the company. My name is Anshuman Das. I'm the founder and CEO of the company Movi. At Movi, we have been offering video audio streaming solutions since 2008, since about 13 years. Our flagship product is Movi, that is used to launch an OTT platform, over-the-top audio video streaming platform. So basically, you can build a platform like Netflix or Hotstar or HBO, Spotify, any kind of audio video streaming platform using Movi. That is our main product. And apart from that, in the recent years, we have diversified into some other products. Like, for example, we have a recommendation engine. We have a billing engine that you can use for any kinds of businesses, including e-commerce and everything. We have a live streaming solution and so on. But the flagship product basically is the Movi, is the company's name. That is the OTT platform provider. In this slide deck, on this webinar, we have about 10 slides. I'll talk for about maybe 15, 20 minutes, like give and take around that. And in the end, we'll have some time for Q&A. So the agenda of this meeting at a high level, I've split the webinar into three categories or three parts. The first part, I'll talk about the recent trend in the social media platforms and how they have evolved, how they have changed. In the older days, when we talk about social media, they used to be mostly Facebook and Twitter. But the news in social media is more about TikTok and now OnlyFans and so on. So they have changed a lot. Old social media platforms used to be more about friends and followers and newsfeed. And the new social media platforms like TikTok, they're more about content, the actual content. They have a lot of similarities. They still have followers and friends and things like that. But the focus and the emphasis is much more on the content creation. So we'll talk about that, what those platforms are, how they have grown, why they have grown, what the current trend is. Why and what the trend is. And then in the end, I have only one slide where I talk about the Movi platform and how we can use Movi to build platforms like this. So first of all, these three use cases or these three like products, I'll talk about that for 5-10 minutes, what these platforms are. Some of you may know them already, but unless you know don't know, so just at a high level introduction to these platforms, these three platforms, TikTok, OnlyFans, and Clubhouse. These three are all different kind. TikTok, I think most of you know, it is mostly a video platform. It is something like YouTube, but it's a combination of YouTube and social and recommendation engine. OnlyFans has grown a lot. Unless you know, currently it has $2 billion of revenue. It is profitable. Most social media platforms are not profitable for a very long time. Even Facebook was not profitable, I believe, for almost 10 years. So OnlyFans has been in the business for only 2 years, less than 2 years, and they're profitable. So very new platforms doing media and social media in the B2C space, being profitable and making $2 billion in revenue, that is almost not heard of. And the catch is that they don't even have a mobile app. So nowadays, almost every business, when they think about it, they first do a mobile app and then they think about the website. They call that as the mobile first generation. But OnlyFans have been successful without even having a mobile app. They're only on the web. So that is a huge platform. And then Clubhouse, that is relatively more new. It is still in beta. But even though it is in beta, it is currently valued at $1 billion. They have 600,000 registered users. And it is growing like mushroom. It is growing like crazy. It started from the Silicon Valley. So mostly it is the VCs and investors, they started using it. But now almost everybody is using it. It is celebrities and book authors and the podcasters, they're all using it. So I'll talk about what these platforms are, how they have grown a little bit, and what the numbers are, and all that. So starting with TikTok. TikTok, most of you know. So basically how this works is that the general people, they post the videos like the way you would post on the YouTube. Now, the difference between YouTube and TikTok is that TikTok is mostly mobile only. the videos are only in the portrait mode, not the landscape mode like it's on the YouTube. And TikTok shows every video, every single video, to at least 6 people. After it shows to 6 people, based on that, it figures out who in their users may like this video. And depending on that, they show the video to more people. So that is all they add to it. So they have a really cool algorithm. So that figures out that depending on this video's taste, depending on the data that they got from the six views, they show to more people. It became crazy popular. Currently, it is banned both in US and India. And even though it is very, very popular. And the popularity was mostly because the difference between TikTok and other platforms like YouTube or Instagram is the logic that on the TikTok, if you use it, the home page or the feed, it is all algorithm based. TikTok recommends to you what you should watch. It is unlike Instagram, where the home page is all feed based. That means you only see the photos of the people that you follow. It is also unlike YouTube, where most of it is basically feed based. So basically, whoever you follow, which channels you subscribe to, you watch their videos first. But TikTok is exclusively mostly an algorithm. So that is how they were different. And because of some other small tweaks, like the portrait only video, the most videos are, I think, less than 30 seconds long. So because of which it became very, very popular. So that is one use case. Second use case is OnlyFans. OnlyFans is less known, but in terms of the actual profit margin and the revenue the company makes, it is crazy. It may be the only profitable company in the social media space that is profitable within the first 1-2 years and making more than $1 billion. So the OnlyFans concept is very simple. It is the celebrities who post their videos. You follow them. And in order to follow celebrities, you have to pay to the channel. So for example, if you want to follow Kim Kardashian, then you follow the channel, you pay her some money, and then when Kim Kardashian is posting some videos, that is available only to her followers. So that is why the name OnlyFans, that the videos are available only to the fans or the people who follow them, and it's not to the whole world. So that is how it makes the platform more exclusive. The fans who follow celebrities, they believe that they're paying some money, but they're getting the videos which is not available on YouTube, which is not available anywhere. It is their celebrities are posting the videos only for them. It has its share of controversy. Some celebrities are using it mostly for the adult videos. There was a controversy about Bella Thorne was using it mostly to fake, that she was saying that she was going to post some videos which she didn't, and she got some money for it. So it has its share of controversy, but I guess that is true for almost every company that is growing. But at a high level, the concept is very simple. There is one more platform like this. It's called as Cameo. Cameo also is very, very popular. Cameo's concept is that it is C-A-M-E-O. It is very similar. The idea is that you can get any celebrity, let's say Tom Cruise or Brad Pitt or Barack Obama, you can get them to record 1 minute of video for X number of dollars. So could be $100, could be $1,000, but they can record a video for you. And that video, people use that mostly for a birthday wish or an anniversary wish. So for example, if I know that my wife is a fan of Tom Cruise, and then Tom Cruise will record a video for 1 minute for $1,000. So I can pay the $1,000 to get a video recorded by Tom Cruise saying specifically to my wife's name that, "Hi Priya," and my wife's name is Priya, by the way, "Hi Priya, happy birthday," and all those things. So it is very similar between OnlyFans and Cameo. They're all video based, but the idea basically is to leverage the video and to close this gap between the celebrities and the fans. Now, this is a very different application. It is equally growing. It is still a media application, but it is not video. It is audio only. It is only audio, but it is also growing like crazy. The idea of the Clubhouse is that think of it like a Zoom, but for audio. People start meeting rooms. The meeting room can be private or it can be public. And they have different permissions that how many people they will allow in the room and all that. But the Clubhouse actual name is Clubhouse Drop-In Audio Chat. So if the meeting room is happening and if it is allowed, depending on the privacy policy, you join the meeting room and you start talking. That is all there to it. So it is mostly an audio conference thing, most like an audio call, audio conference meeting room like that. But it's very popular because Zoom has been growing like crazy, as I'm sure you know. But Zoom has a video fatigue. Video fatigue basically means that most people don't want to be on the camera all the time. Most people don't want to look at the screen for next 1 hour, 2 hours in the whole meeting. So because of that, audio also is growing equally proportionally, like video is. Netflix is growing, Spotify also is growing. Zoom is growing and Clubhouse is growing. So both video and audio, they equally are growing. And Clubhouse chose to be audio only. But the concept is similar to Zoom. But unlike in the Zoom where you schedule a meeting invite and you add in the calendar and so on, but the Clubhouse is more about meeting rooms are available. The people who are hosting, they make the rooms available already. And you browse the meeting rooms and depending on the policy, you join in. It is getting very popular because audio seems to be more less stressful as compared to video. And depending on the room, it can be a great tool for learning something new. Can be you can join into to listen to some celebrities discussing something. You can join in some interview that somebody's interviewing somebody else and you're listening in. So they are really harnessing the power of the audio in the Clubhouse. Currently, it is still in beta, but it is still valued at $1 billion. So you can imagine that how these primarily social media / media companies, which are growing really fast, really quick, within 1-2 years time frame. So now we'll talk a bit about how these companies are different than the traditional social media platforms. When we talk about traditional social media platforms, usually we think of companies called as Facebook, Twitter, even Instagram, or even WhatsApp. So those are primarily what we call as the traditional or the old school social media platforms. They are not exactly old yet because Facebook is still number one platform in the entire world and they're still growing. But about 5-6 years ago, when you ask somebody what is a social platform, then the first name comes to mind is Facebook and then Twitter and so on. But nowadays, these new platforms are growing really big. And the way they are growing, the trend is that after 5 years from now, Facebook is going to start decreasing and more people are going to be on these new platforms. And that is already happening. The younger people are more on Snapchat and on TikTok than they are on the Facebook. So if you think about it, whatever the young people use today, they also use the same platform as they grow up. So the current teenagers, the 12, 14 years old, if they're going to be spending more time on TikTok, as they get older, most likely they'll be using still on TikTok and they'll be using Facebook less. So that is the growth trend right now. Now, the difference between those two platforms, more like Facebook kind and the TikTok kind, is that the Facebook kind in the older days, it was focused more about the news feed. What I mean by the news feed is that basically you become friends with some people or you follow them on the Twitter. And then on your homepage, what you see is the news feed. That means whatever they post, you see that. So you only see the content, which can be a text, can be a video, can be an image of the people that you are friends with or you follow them. But now the new platforms, they are more about the content. So it is less about who you follow and who your friends are. It is more about algorithm based and it is about content based. They still have the friends feature. On the TikTok, you can follow people. Only fans, you follow celebrities. So they all have those features. But on the homepage, they focus mostly on the content. That as you open if you open the TikTok app, it feels more like YouTube or a video app, then it feels more like a social app. If you open the OnlyFans, then the homepage, it is all about videos. It is not about who do you follow and things like that. So these new age social media platforms, they are very heavy and primarily on the content driven. There is a saying I have read in some blog or book somewhere that nowadays almost every company is a media company. They just don't know it yet. you might be aware that Facebook has so much content from what we call as the UGC or the user generated content. But apart from that they also produce their own shows. Apple has so much content through iTunes and podcast, but they also produce their own shows. So almost nowadays, almost every company, after they get to a scale, they produce their own content. Other content can be video, can be audio, can be images, can be text, can be blogs, whatever it is. But almost every company, they are trying to produce content because people are more hungry for content. There is no thing called as enough content, right? So Netflix is growing like crazy, but people still want Disney Plus. Disney Plus is growing, but people still want Discovery Plus. So almost every company, they are trying to create more content and trying to figure out how to display the content in a more meaningful way. So that is how they leverage the social media angle, that it is the content is the primary factor, but it is still driven by the people you follow and the friends that you are friends with.
Why such trend? Why it is happening?
So that you understand and you can judge for yourself if you think this trend is going to grow in the future or not. This is our own analysis based on this industry for last 10 plus years. The analysis basically is that before Facebook, we didn't know how to make friends on the internet. We made friends mostly in our neighborhood. We used to go to restaurants and we used to go to play a game, and it was mostly between our friends and family. After Facebook, the world changed, and people then became friends with strangers. So now on the Facebook, more than half of the people on my Facebook, I haven't met them even once. They're strangers. I found them on the internet and I liked what they're posting and I became friends with them. Same thing on the Twitter, same thing on the Instagram and so on. So what happened is that in the beginning, the number of friends somebody has or the number of people somebody follows, that seems to be reasonable within 20, 30, like that. But now the average number of friends on the Facebook one person has is 338 people. Similarly on the Twitter, the average number of people that somebody follows on the Twitter is more than 200, 300, 400, like that. So the idea basically is that when the number of people that you are friends with or you follow, when that becomes too much, then that becomes less meaningful. If you have five friends, then you know who they are. You have them in your contact list and you know who to call and all this and like that. But if your contact list is 5,000, then it becomes less meaningful because you can't keep track of everything. So then what happens is that the content they produce becomes more important. If I'm following 30 people on Twitter, out of 30, if 10 people are my friends or family, my brother, my wife, my mom, whoever it is, and 20 people are other people who I follow them to learn something new on the Twitter, could be an investor, could be a book author, I care more about their post than I care about the post from my own family member, because their content is more interesting to me. So that is what is happening, that as people's circle grew, then the content they produce became more important than the actual people. There is also a new term for that that is now growing also really crazy, that is called as creator economy or the passion economy. So what is happening is that as more people are creating more content, then there is a democratization of content, that almost everybody can create content. It is not only by the Hollywood studios anymore. Now almost everybody with an iPhone camera, they can make a short movie. Anybody can be a famous celebrity on the TikTok. On the TikTok, nowadays there are YouTube stars. Mr. Beast is a YouTube star. He's the biggest star on the YouTube. And he's now more popular than the top Hollywood stars in the eye of the teenagers. So that is what is happening, that the normal people are good creating content, and the content is not limited to only one category. It doesn't have to be a movie. It can be anything. It can be simply you talking about your own interest. It can be your hobby. You're talking about that. You are funny. You are angry. Whatever it is. So that is creating this, what they call as the creator or the passion economy, that basically you create content that you're passionate about, and that is how you make your money. There are more examples, as you can see on the screen right now, and there are many more examples. At a high level, these are some more platforms apart from this TikTok and OnlyFans and Cameo and so on. On the Teachable, Patreon, there are other platforms like this where basically those platforms are there where the content creator goes there to create a content, which can be the Teachable, it is a video course. On the Twitch, it is a video game that you're playing. On the Substack, it is a newsletter. And the Patreon Gumroad, it can be any of those things. It can be writing an ebook or having a vlog, a video blog, and so on like that. So almost in all these categories, people are creating content, but they are primarily all about creating media content, video or audio content, and having a social angle to it. Building such apps and using Movie. Now, Movie, I'm assuming that you're in this webinar, that means that you know a bit about Movie, what we do at a high level. So at a high level, Movie allows you to create your own video audio store. One of the features that we have is the UGC. If you enable UGC, it allows the end users of your platform to upload content. So UGC basically is what YouTube is different from Netflix. Netflix has no UGC. You can't upload your own video. There's only Netflix selects the videos what they want us to see. On the YouTube, almost anybody can upload a video. So that we call it the UGC. So we have that feature. So using which you can create any of these platforms. So basically you're enabling your end users to be able to create content and upload content on the platform. And to have that available on a website or Android app and iPhone app and TV app and so on. And apart from that, we have a AI-based recommendation engine. We have many different payment methods, including subscription and coupon and voucher and one-time payments and donations and so on like that. And the last, but not the least, is a custom template. So if you look at something like OnlyFans or Cameo or Clubhouse, they look very different than the way it looks on Netflix and HBO. Because Netflix, HBO, Amazon Prime, they are more of the video streaming platforms. Now these are a bit different. But that is possible using Movie because you can have your own design. So using these features, you can create almost any platform that I talked about in this meeting. You can create something like OnlyFans, you can create something like TikTok, you can create something like Cameo, any of these video audio platforms which have a social angle to it, you can build that using Movie. One thing that we don't have currently, but it is coming up in a roadmap, is a social feed. So social feed basically will allow you that the user can follow other users and they will see a feed of their activity on their homepage. So that is one feature that we don't have currently, but that is coming soon in a roadmap. And when we have that, then that will complete the whole picture that you have UGC, you have a recommendation engine, and you have the payment methods. You can design the app or the store any way you want to. And you also have the social feed to it, which allow you to see the activity feed of the people that you follow. So that is the end of my presentation. Thank you again for spending your time. Good afternoon or evening or good morning, depending on where you are in the world. Thank you again very much. Thank you. Bye.